look at you. My whole life falls in line. I prayed for you.
Gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and I do.
You may be seated. Friends and family, we are gathered today in the presence of God to witness Mark and Ashley Rose's marriage promise to each other. Marriage was introduced by God, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and is to be held in honor among all people. Mark and Ashley Rose, the promise which you are about to make with each other is meant to be a beautiful and sacred expression of your love for each other. As you pledge your vows and as you commit your lives to each other, we ask that you do so in all seriousness and yet with a deep sense of joy, with a deep conviction that you are committing yourself to a dynamic and growing relationship of trust, mutual support, and caring love. Let's pray. God, we thank you for this beautiful day that you have given us. And God, I thank you for this gathering of friends and family who have both played significant roles in shaping and forming who Mark is and who Ashley Rose is. Today is not only a celebration of the two of them, but of all of us, because we have all been witnesses to your great work in their lives. We ask that you bless them and bless the vows that they are about to make. Amen. Mark, will you have Ashley Rose to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holiest state of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her and keep her in sickness and in health, and remain loyal to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Ashley Rose, will you have Mark to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holiest state of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor him and keep him in sickness and in health, and remain loyal to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
We will now hear a reading from God's word.
Put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassionate hearts, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience, bearing with one another, and, if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other. As the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him.
Mark and Ashley Rose, you made it. In just a few minutes, you'll officially be married. And I want you to take a moment to take in the significance and the beauty of what is happening right now. I believe God has blessed you both immensely. And all these amazing friends and family that are here are a reminder of how much God has truly given you. I want to thank you for allowing me to play a small part in your big day today. Mark, I've had the privilege of knowing you for almost 14 years. As your youth pastor, I met you when you were in eighth grade. At the time, you were tall, you were quiet, and you were really funny. But as I got to know you, I learned there's a lot more to you below the surface. I learned that you are a man of integrity. You have incredible work ethic. You don't follow the crowd. You have deep convictions. You're humble. You don't judge others. And while you come across as tough and stoic, deep down you are a big softy, full of compassion, and there's nothing you wouldn't do for those that you love. And yes, you're still tall, quiet, and really funny. Mark, it's truly a privilege to know you. Ashley, please don't forget the dash rose. I haven't known you for long, but I've known about you for quite a while. I first heard about you from my sister Lori, better known as Trainer Bo to some of you. And she told me how special and remarkable you are. And as I've gotten to know you over the last 6 months, I've learned that she was spot on. First off, you are a teacher, which under the best circumstances is an extremely difficult and important job. But we all know the last 14 months have not been the best circumstance. But you have continued to pour into your students with excellence, grace, and care. You are a phenomenal teacher. You have an incredible work ethic. You look for and you see the best in people. You're selfless, you're patient, you're determined, you're kind, and you're filled and overflowing with beauty and grace. You are a remarkable person, Ashley Rose. Mark and Ashley Rose, in a lot of ways, you two are a great match. You've already done a lot of hard work in your relationship. You do a great job of supporting each other, of communicating with each other, of working through tension, of having tough conversations, of giving grace and knowing when you just need to shut up and go for a drive. I'm so excited for your marriage because I believe you two complement each other so well. But while compatibility is very helpful in marriage, commitment is what keeps marriages together. Today, the two of you make a commitment. You make a commitment to stay with each other for better, for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish for as long as you both shall live. I know you're both aware of the complexity and difficulty of this commitment, and yet the beauty and rarity of it as well. So how does one keep a commitment like you two are making today? There are many ways I could answer that question, but I know we have a party to get to. It's really hot, and some of us are wearing suit jackets and ties. So I'll keep it short. I believe one of the keys for a successful marriage is collaboration, working together. Ecclesiastes 4:12 says these words, "Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken." There are a lot of ways you can interpret this verse, but in the marriage context, it's pretty clear. The first part of the verse says, "Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves." Mark and Ashley Rose, I know you two like to spend a lot of time upstate, and God only knows what critters, creatures, and crazy people you might encounter when you're up there. So great news, as the verse says, two can defend themselves better than one. But in all seriousness, we all know that this world throws some pretty overwhelming challenges at us. The last 14 months is a great example of that. Because of your commitment today, you can continue to defend each other and to walk through these challenges as a couple and know that you are not alone. But the verse ends by saying these profound words, "A cord of three strands is not quickly broken." Now, we could argue about what that third cord should be. Some might say family, other friends, others Founders All Day IPA. And I would argue that at least two of those three are irreplaceable. But I believe the third cord needed in a marriage is a relationship with God. I believe that God is the creator, the savior, the father and friend we all need. And I know that you both have a great respect, appreciation, and belief in God. And my encouragement is to continue to find ways to include him in your marriage. He's the source of love, of grace, of peace, of hope, of wisdom and truth. He's the only person who can complete your marriage. He's the only person who can give you the supernatural ability to sacrifice for each other and stay committed to each other for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish for as long as you both shall live. That is my prayer and my hope for you both. May God bless you as you begin and walk this beautiful journey together. Now let's get you married. Mark, will you repeat after me? I, Mark, take you, Ashley Rose.
I, Mark, take you, Ashley Rose.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Ashley Rose, repeat after me. I, Ashley Rose, take you, Mark.
I, Ashley Rose, take you, Mark.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health. In
sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Mark, do you have a token of your love? Do you, Mark, give this ring as a token that you will keep this promise and perform these vows? Mark, will you repeat after me?
Ashley Rose, I give you this ring.
Ashley Rose, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And with all that I have.
And with all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
The Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Ashley Rose, do you have a token of your love? Do you, Ashley Rose, give this ring as a token that you will keep these promises and perform these vows? Ashley Rose, repeat after me.
Mark, I give you this ring.
Mark, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And all that I am.
And with all that I have.
And with all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
And in the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
With this ring, with this I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
Let us pray. God, I thank you that you look down this afternoon with great joy, knowing that a beautiful thing has happened. And so as Mark and Ashley Rose begin their marriage together, I ask that you bless them. God, that you would bless their families. You would bless all that they come in contact with. God, that today would be a reminder of what you have done in their lives and the unity and the commitment that they have made. Amen. By the authority given to me by God and the state of New Jersey, I now pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mark, you may now kiss your bride. Those whom God hath joined together, let no one separate. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Mark and Ashley Rose Hook.
How long will I love you? I don't really know. I'd like to think forever is how far we could go. So let me paint picture of how it's gonna be the day you don't mean everything to me. When a nickel's worth a dollar and gold ain't worth a dime, I stop loving you, honey, they'll be driving Buicks to the moon. You don't have to worry about what comes to pass.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the ceremony. You are invited to continue celebrating by making your way to the pavilion for cocktail hour.
Gentlemen, we're going to have your attention, please. If you go up, please find your seats if you haven't done so already.
We're going to be introducing some very special people to you
to begin our celebration for Ashley, Rose, and Mark. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you to the beautiful Waterloo Village here in Byram, New Jersey. If you could kindly direct your attention to my left, your right, put your hands together for our parents of the bride, Edwin and Teresa Sherman.
This will be everlasting love. This
next, we have our parents of the groom, Peter and Susan Hook.
This will be the first time anyone has loved me. Oh, I'm so glad.
Ladies and gentlemen, now we have some very special people, our stars, our bridal party. If you could put your hands together for Danielle Green, Dylan Sherman, and Colin Sherman. Amanda DeYoung and Kyle DeYoung. Put your hands together for Anna Puglisi, escorted by Matt Talber. Keep it going for Jamie Hook, escorted by best man Daniel Hook. And last last but not least, we have Kelsey Ganen, our matron of honor, and another maid of honor, Carly Ganen.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you could all please rise at this time. Please rise. Let me hear you if you're here for our bride tonight. Let me hear you make some noise if you're here for our groom tonight. Please welcome, for the first time anywhere, his husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Mark and Ashley Rose Holmes. All right, at this time, we're going to ask Mark to escort his beautiful bride out to the center of the dance floor so they may share their first dance together as husband and wife, a beautiful song by Mr. Alan Jackson.
He said, I never felt this way in my heart as I do now. I never wanted anything more in my life as I do now. I can't describe what I'm feeling inside. I'm asking for forever tonight. And she said, I'll be with you, and I'll stay with you, and I'll love you all of my days. And I'll walk with you through life, I'll dance with you, and I hope you feel the way that I do. And he said, I do. So they walked hand in hand till they got lost somewhere in time. Then the sun woke up and put the moon to bed with its light. And he asked her once more if she's really sure, 'cause what we have, you know, there's no cure. And she said, I'll be with you, I'll stay with you, and I'll love you all of my days. And I'll walk with you through life, I'll dance with you, and I hope you feel the way that I do. And he said, I do. And she said, I'll be with you, and I'll stay with you, and I'll love you all of my days. And I'll walk with you through life, I'll dance with you, and I hope you feel the way that I do. And he said, I do.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together once again for our newlyweds, Mark and Ashley Rose. Now we're going to ask Ashley Rose to escort her father out to the center of the dance floor. Put your hands together for our bride and her wonderful father, Edwin.
Your mom and I are a mess, seeing you in that dress. Our little girl is now grown, and I remember how sweet when you danced on my feet. Now you stand on your own. You'll always be my little girl, my whole life, my whole world, my little girl. This dance is more than just a dance. It gives me one more chance to show the world how proud I am of you. And as we God could create,
as I realize I have to give you away. You'll always be my little girl.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands one more time for our beautiful bride and her wonderful father, Edgar. All right, next we're going to ask our groom to escort his mother out to the center of the dance floor. Put your hands together for our groom, Mark, and his beautiful mother, Susan.
Boy, you're going to know it all. You'll think you're 10 feet tall. Run like you're bulletproof. Total a car or two. Boy, you're gonna hate this town. Wish you could burn it down. That fire in your eyes is 20 counties wide. But boy, you're gonna love 17. And boy, you'll do some stupid things. You're gonna drive and kiss and throw a punch and grow up way too fast. You're gonna drop the ball, hit the wall, and break some hearts like glass. I know you will, 'cause you're a part of me and a part of you, who will always be a boy. You gonna be so stubborn. You get that from your mother. I already see it now. You weren't built for backing down. Boy, there'll be a small town night. You'll fall for her sky blue eyes. When she's in your hands, you'll think you're a man and not a boy. She'll make you lose your mind. Boy, you'll be every reason why. You're gonna drive and kiss and throw a punch and grow up way too fast. You're gonna drop the ball, hit the wall, and break some hearts like glass. I know you will. 'Cause you're a part of me and a part of you will always be mine, boy.
Please, ladies and gentlemen, one more time for our groom, Mark, and his beautiful mother, Susan. At this time, we're going to kindly ask everyone to please find their seats. We have a few people that we're going to speak on behalf of our bride and groom. And once again, folks, can you kindly find your seats as we call up some very special people to speak on behalf of our bride and groom shortly. All right, ladies and gentlemen, first we're going to call up our father of the groom, who's going to say a prayer for us this evening. She said, I'll be with you, and I'll
stay with you. All of my... I'd ask that you would bow your heads and pray with me. Gracious Heavenly Father, as we come together at this special occasion to celebrate Mark and Ashley Rose, we first acknowledge that all good things around us come from heaven above. We thank you for the beauty of this day and for the abundance of this food that comes from your hand. And we are thankful that we can share in this with family and friends. Lord, Sue and I are so blessed to welcome Ashley Rose as our daughter. We are thankful for the wonderful woman you created her to be, and that you created Mark and Ashley Rose to be husband and wife. Father, we pray that you would bless their marriage and be ever present in their home, to guide them and instruct them in all the good times and the hard times, in their weeping and rejoicing. May they seek your guidance as they grow together and experience a joy and peace that can only come from you. Now, Lord, we pray that, these words that Moses spoke to the Israelites would be an inspiration and a comfort to Mark and Ashley Rose. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. In the name of our Savior Jesus Christ, amen.
Okay, next, we're going to call our father of the bride on up to give a nice little welcome toast. Put your hands together for Mr. Ed Sherman, please, everybody.
I just wanted to give thanks for such a wonderful wedding ceremony today. It was beautiful. I just wanted to say that my little girl has become a beautiful woman. Life is a journey. It has a lot of ups and downs, but when two people meet, fall in love, and marry, it's a true blessing. The Sherman family welcomes Mark into our family, as I know the Hook family welcomes Ashley Rose into theirs. I thank all the family and friends who can be here today, and those who could not attend but are thinking of you, and those who are no longer with us but are with us in spirit. Enjoy this special day as we celebrate the wedding of Ashley Rose and Mark. And I'd like to just end with a little Irish blessing. May your mornings bring joy and your evenings bring peace. May your troubles grow few as your blessings increase. May the saddest day of your future be no worse than the happiest day of your past. May your hands be ever clasped in friendship and your hearts joined forever in love. Your lives are very special. God has touched you in many ways. May his blessings rest upon you and fill you all your coming days. God bless you.
Thank you, Ed. Nice round of applause for Ed. Everybody did an excellent job. Next, we're going to call our matron and maid of honor on up, Kelsey and Carly. Some encouragement for these gals right here. They're going to be coming up. You're allowed to hoot and holler a little bit. Ladies got their drink. Well done. And their phones. It's 2021. That's where the speeches are.
Hello, everybody. Woohoo! We are here to celebrate these two wonderful people. Yeah, thanks so much. Ashley Rose and Mark, we must take a moment to celebrate the journey that you guys have, you know, everything that brought you two together.
Once upon a time, in a bar called Shortways, two individuals had their eye on each other, but they were too shy to talk to each other. On the encouragement of Marge, our grandmother, a.k.a. Marge the matchmaker, they were able to break that barrier. A few nights later, Mark very smoothly asked for her number. I was there, I know. The first date rolled into the second and the third. You met each other's friends and families. Mark started to dress fancier. And before we knew it, we were celebrating the milestones of your engagement, buying your first house, and adopting Hank.
Over the years, you have grown into the strong couple that you two are today. I think we speak for everyone in this room when we say we cannot wait to see what the next chapter in your life brings.
Ashley Rose, you've been a close friend to our entire family for many years. You've seen us through tough times and celebrated with us through the best times. You are the most enthusiastic, kindest, most caring person. You're always down to go anywhere or do anything. You have so much love to give. Anyone who is the recipient of that love is truly lucky.
Now, this is the part where we usually tell some embarrassing stories about the bride and the groom, but we both know, well, I know, that you guys probably have way more dirt on us and me than we have on you two, so we're just gonna skip through that part and get right on. We're gonna cut that right out. Mark, if we were to dream up the perfect man for Ashley Rose, you would be it. You're easygoing, motivated, and an all-around good time guy. We are so grateful that Ashley Rose found you because you love her in the way that she truly deserves.
There is so much love in this room here tonight. So today, on your wedding day, please take a moment and soak it in. Look around the room. When times get tough, remember this day. Remember the promises you made and the vows you've exchanged. Remember the feeling of being surrounded by your loved ones. We are all here for you and because of you.
So everybody, please raise your glasses and let's toast to the new Mr. and Mrs. Hook. May God bless this union.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, one more time for Kelsey and Carly. Did a great job. All right, we have one gentleman left, our best man, Daniel. Please give him a nice round of applause.
You ready, sir?
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody, for coming to join in the celebration of the wedding of Mark and Ashley Rose. It's amazing to see the outpouring of love and support for our newlywed couple. I specifically want to thank Ed and Terry for making this possible, for bringing up such a wonderful daughter who has brought my brother real happiness. Ashley Rose, you look absolutely beautiful tonight. I know it sounds cliche, but you make my brother a better man. It was abundantly clear that you affected him because every time that he looks at you, he has the biggest smile on his face. And of course, Mark, you're the best brother anybody could ever have. You've always been there for me. I'm so grateful that you asked me to be your best man. It's a great honor, and I'm proud to stand up here with you tonight. There's only one story that seemed appropriate for me standing up here to tell. There's a story that Mark likes to tell about a family ski trip that we went to in Utah, where I dragged him down every trail that was marked danger, ski at your own risk. I seem to recall the story a little bit differently. You see, it might seem semantic, but what I remember is that Mark followed me down all those trails, perhaps begrudgingly. And after we had spent a morning skiing all over the mountain, we stopped on a trail that was appropriately called Massacre to catch our breath. I reached into my pocket to pull out the family camera and take a picture of his absolutely cheerful face, and I didn't have the camera any longer. So Mark followed me down every trail that we had done again until we made it back to that fateful spot. I hadn't found the camera. I was pretty upset. But this is what I remember. Mark, you looked at me and you told me that the camera wasn't important. It was the time that we'd gotten to spend together. You see, Mark, behind his grumpy attitude and sarcastic remarks, is the kind of brother and the kind of friend and now the kind of husband who will follow you wherever you go and always be there for you. Jesus explains in John chapter 15, my command is this, love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no other one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. And I pray that your marriage would be a model of Christ's love for us, that you would put each other's needs before your own, and that you would always be there to love and nurture each other. So if you'll join me in a toast to the newlyweds, here's to a lifetime of love for each other.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause for our best man, Dan, everybody. We're going to ask everyone to kindly remain seated. Kindly remain seated as our first course will be out momentarily. And then after you enjoy that wonderful appetizer, we're going to get you out dancing and celebrating Asher and Rose and Mark. Once again, please remain seated as our first course will be out shortly.
To the sea, to the sea.
Wobble, baby, wobble, baby, wobble, baby.